way that Kell Brook has aged, and the way Sean Porter has aged, and the fight that Sean Porter gave Errol Spence Jr., you know, I didn't like the beginning for Errol. I didn't like the beginning. I liked the ending. I didn't like the beginning. You know, I think Sean has a lot that he can still offer in the welterweight division. And, you know, I think he's the one to test a lot of fighters. He tested Ugas. We saw something good out of Ugas in that fight, but he didn't get the judges to give him the fight. He showed great boxing technique. But at the end of the day, man, you know, he's got another chance to redeem himself tomorrow night. And I'm looking forward to that.
So do you think it's legit when we call Terrence Crawford the number one best pound-for-pound fighter in the world?
No. Number one pound-for-pound? He did great things at 140. His very limited resume at 147. I think he'd have to go through a few different names at 147 before you can fully legitimately say the things that just came out of your mouth.
So who's the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world?
I don't know. First off, that's a wish list. I don't think it's a real thing. I just think it's the biggest debatable thing on the planet, pound for pound. I used to argue Andre Ward was pound for pound, but nobody wanted to listen because Floyd Mayweather was pound for pound, and he never lost, so Andre Ward had to be number two forever. And guess what? When you're pound for pound number two, nobody cares. I was pound for pound number seven at one time. Nobody cares, okay? The only thing anybody's ever going to talk about is pound for pound number one. So you just put Crawford up in there. I don't know if he really deserves that title, but I don't think it's a real ranking anyway. So
he beat Sean Porter. You want that fight?
I take all fights, especially I'm strapless. Where the straps at? Where the cash at? Where the straps at? You know?
Then I'll take. Ain't doing much. Take a step back. Cause it's Elie Seckbach.